Hello students, I am Dr. Gajendra Purohit and you are watching my YouTube channel with videos on engineering mathematics and BSc content, and if you are preparing for exams which require higher mathematics, then my channel will be very helpful for you. You can find my videos on iTab or in the description covering linear algebra, real analysis, modern algebra and ODE/PDE. I have uploaded videos on many topics which you can watch and learn from, and today we will study reducible to homogeneous differential equations, and there are some good questions on it. And I will provide a clear explanation of how to solve this type of differential equation in the simplest manner possible. I want to tell that I previously discussed homogeneous differential equations in an earlier lecture, so you can refer to that lecture on iTab for a better understanding on this topic. Here we have a non-homogeneous differential equation that can be reduced to a homogeneous differential equation. I want to tell you something, that whenever we have a differential equation given as dy by dx is equal to ax plus by plus c, take a1, b1, c1, and here we have upon a2x plus b2y plus c2. If here the coefficient of these a1 by a2 term is not equal to the coefficient of these, for example, if we take this term dy by dx is equal to x plus 2y minus 1 divided by, and in the denominator we take 2x plus y plus 1, you can see the coefficient of x is 1 by 2 and the coefficient of y is 2 by 1. And since they are not equal, so it means that we can reduce this equation to a homogeneous equation. And there is one more type. Suppose we have a differential equation dy by dx where a1x plus b1y plus c1 upon a2x, and the last term is b2y plus c2. If you notice here, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. That means both ratios are equal. And in this case, you might wonder about the next step. I've already uploaded videos explaining how to solve these questions using the concept of reducible to variables separable. Since the ratio is not equal, it is reducible to homogeneous. If the ratio were equal, then it is reducible to variable separable. Now let me explain how. Let me present an example here. Suppose we have the differential equation dy by dx equals x plus y plus 1 upon 2x plus 2y plus 3. Let's suppose that the given equation is, as we can notice that the ratio of the coefficients of these two is 1 by 2 equals 1 by 2, meaning both are equal. And as I explained in reducible to variable separable equations, the concept I explained is that if a function appears once or it repeats more than once, as you can see 2 is the common factor here, then we will assume x plus y as t. By doing this, we can easily solve this differential equation, because after assuming it as t, the variables will get separated in x and t. Then you can substitute the value of t and solve the equation. Thus, it is reducible to variable separable. When it does not become equal, the equation is reducible to homogeneous. Today, we will discuss how to solve the equation if it is not equal. So first let's learn how do we approach such a question here. As you can see that we are given dy by dx is equal to y plus x minus 2 upon y minus x minus 4. Now at this point we will assume small x equals to capital X plus h and small y is equal to capital Y plus k. Further, if we differentiate this, then we know small dx is equal to capital dx and small dy is equal to capital dy. When we put this value here, and let me tell that when we put the value of this, we get capital dy by dx. Here, when we substitute the value of this small y into the equation, we will arrive at the following result. Capital Y plus k, and here at this point we will have plus capital X plus h minus 2 in the numerator of the expression divided by. And the value of y here will be, as you can see here, y plus k minus, and further we will be writing capital X plus h minus 4. When we solve this, we find that dy by dx is equal to, and as you can see, we obtain the following result, y plus x. And further in this equation, we will be getting k plus h minus 2 divided by. And in the denominator of this term, we will have y minus x, x plus k, k minus h minus 4. I want to tell you that for this question, we have done so much to do these steps. There is a trick to it. If you have any such differential equation, then you can easily solve it here. I want to mention first that to make this homogeneous, you need to set this term and this term to 0. Which means we will put k plus h minus 2 as 0 and k minus h minus 4 as 0. After doing this, so in this process, this differential equation that we have will be y plus x minus y minus x. And I would like to point out that we can avoid these steps altogether in such a case. If we have any differential equation with a capital letter, we assume it represents that letter and replace the small letter with the capital letter. Replace the small letter with the capital letter and leave the rest as is. Do not write it. Also, wherever there is y, write k, and where we have x, replace it with h. See, this y is replaced by k. Simply set this entire term to 0 and you will have this task done here. Don't overthink it. You can directly take this step. It will follow from here. I've explained the reason behind it before, so we don't need to waste time on it. I mentioned this to suggest that instead of solving and separating it to set to zero later, it's better to replace X and Y with capital letters when they appear. And wherever there is Y, replace it with K. And H in place of X. Set it equal to zero and it is done. Therefore, students, this concept that I explained was for your knowledge. Now take out the values of H and K on the side. So when we solve this, then this H cancels with H. The value of K that we get is 2K. And when we add this, it simplifies to minus 6 equal to 0. From this, you can see that the value of K is 3. And when we put 3 for the value of K, the value of H will be minus 1. Put this value here. We will use this value in the equation. I will explain the next steps later. For now, let's move forward. The differential equation we have is dy by dx. Students, this equation is dy by dx is equal to y plus x upon y minus x. Since this is a homogeneous equation in 1 degree, we can solve it by using the substitution capital Y equals small v into x. This is the approach we take in such cases. Thus, when we differentiate this, we get dy by dx. We write it here as v plus x dv by dx. And this is the value that we get here. Now, take this value and put it here. So, this will become v plus x dv by dx. And here at this point, this y is replaced with vx. And we have vx here as well. When we solve it, x cancels out from both sides. Further in this equation, this will be x dv by dx and this will be v plus 1 upon v minus 1 minus v. And now when we take the LCM of this, so let me just tell one thing. When we take the LCM, and this is not a relevant term, so when we solve it, we will get x dv by dx. We take the LCM of the expression, we get the LCM as v minus 1. This will be v plus 1, and when you multiply this with minus v, it will be minus v square, and here it will become plus v. When we simplify this, we will have x dv by dx. And at this point, we will be getting 1 plus 2v minus v square upon v minus 1. Now, let's proceed by separating this variable v in this step and separate x. So, let me write it here. So, this will become v minus 1 upon 1 plus 2v minus v square into dv is equal to dx by x. Students, as you can see that these are separated, so consider this term t. So, this comes out as 1 plus 2v minus v square. And as I assume it as t, then it comes out as 2 minus 2v dv is equal to dt. We can take 2 common from here and move it to the other side, which will become 1 minus v. dv is equal to dt by 2. Now, notice it, we have v minus 1 and 1 minus v here. To simplify this, let's take minus as common to get 1 minus v dv and take this minus on the other side. So, this will be minus dt by 2. Now, we will put this value here. I hope the things are clear to you. Now, we will keep the value. Thus, we get minus dt by 2t. And this specific fraction will be equal to the following expression. Dx upon x plus log c. This can be considered as log c here. And when we integrate this expression here, then we get minus 1 by 2. Log t is equal to, and here in this expression we will get log x plus log c. And as we can notice, send this 2 and this minus on the other side to further simplify this equation. Thus, in this step we will be getting log t is equal to minus 2 log x. If it is constant, then we can just leave it as it is. We don't need to change it. Suppose here it was c dash, and we will get the new constant c. Is it clear? Now we will multiply it, which makes it an expression in the form of log t and log c upon x square, as here this is minus 2. Now, in the next step, the log is being cancelled from both sides. I am cancelling the log now. Also, now I am cleaning this up here. As we don't need this anymore, so I am cleaning this part here. Furthermore, coming to the question, as both the logs are cancelled now. Thus, at this point, we will get t is equal to c upon x square. And in the next step, let's cross multiply it. Therefore, we get x square t is equal to c, as we have x square here and t was assumed to be. And as you can see here in this expression, t was assumed this. Thus, we have 1 plus 2v minus v square is equal to c. Now, if you remember that previously, wherever we had v in the expression, as we considered y is equal to vx, if you remember, the value of this v will be capital Y divided by x. And we will put this value here. So, this will be x square 1 plus 2 in this following expression. And here in this equation, we have y divided by x minus y square divided by x square equal to c. I will erase this part of the equation as it's not needed. And we will simplify this expression now, right? Coming to the equation to simplify this. Let's take the LCM of x square to simplify this. After taking the LCM of x square, we get x square plus 2xy and minus y square divided by x square. So, x square and x square will cancel out. Now we have x square plus 2xy minus y square is equal to c. But since our answer should be in terms of small x and small y, and as we know that we assumed here, and let me reiterate it, we assume that this small x is equal to this term. Now the value of capital X that we have is small x minus h. That will be the value of capital X at this point here. And the value of capital Y is small y minus k, because we have taken h and k to the other side. Now we have the value of k as minus 1. I will write this as x plus 1, because we will keep minus, and here the value of k is 3. So that's why we will have y minus 3. And wherever you have capital X and y, just put that value here. Thus, as you can see, the value of x will be, if we notice, then the value of capital X will be the whole square of x plus 1 plus 2 into x plus 1, and by putting the value of y, we will be getting y minus 3 minus. And here at this place, we will get whole square of y minus 3 is equal to c. This is the answer that we get here. So this is how we solve this question. It is a little bit lengthy, but if you do the calculation correctly, then you can easily solve this question. Let's take another question so that you fully understand the concept. Let's take this question here. I'll get straight to the point without wasting time. So let's see, what do we have to assume for this question? Take a moment to consider this carefully. Now, here's what we assume. Small x is equal to capital X plus h, and small y equals capital Y plus k. We assume this. And put this value here, as I showed you in the previous example, that we directly put capital dy by dx here. Replace small x with capital X and small y with capital Y wherever you find them. This will be 2x plus y. Now, wherever we have x here, we will proceed to replace the x with h plus 2k minus 3. And here it will be 2h plus k minus 3 equal to 0. And this equation is also equal to 0. Solving both equations, we get h as 1 and k as 1. Now, these h and k are 1. And we will substitute these values. You can see this is capital X is equal to small x minus h, as h goes to this side and the value of h is 1. So capital X is equal to small x minus 1. The same way we will see that capital Y is equal to small y minus k, and we know that. The value of capital Y has to be put here in the expression at the end. We know that capital Y is equal to small y minus 1. These values will be put in the final solution. So coming back to the equation, as we are aware that this equation is called a homogeneous differential equation. Thus, to solve this, we let Y is equal to Vx. Capital Y is equal to small Vx here. Now, when we differentiate this, then in that case, this x becomes 1 and this term becomes x dv by dx. Now take this value and put it here. And when we take this value and put it here, then it will be v plus x. dv by dx is equal to x. And further in the equation, we get 2vx divided by 2x plus vx. Here we get x common and then it gets cancelled. And now we will get x dv by dx is equal to 1 plus. And here it becomes 2v upon 2 plus v. And if we calculate the value of x dv by dx, then you will obtain the value as follows, 1 plus 2v upon 2 plus v minus v. When we solve this now, so here we have the value of this as x dv by dx. And when we solve this expression, then we will obtain 2 plus v. Let's take its LCM. So we get 1 plus. And further in this term, we get minus 2v minus v square by multiplying after taking the LCM. So these 2v terms get cancelled out. As you can notice that dv by dx is equal to 1 minus v square upon 2 plus v. Now separate the variables here in this. Now in the next step, we have 2 plus v upon 1 minus v square into dv, which is equal to dx upon x. Let's perform its integration and take log c. And further in this step, let's separate them. So this becomes 2 upon 1 minus v square into dv. Here we will solve this, then we get v upon 1 minus v square dv. Its integration will be log x. Therefore, it becomes log c. Now pay attention to the integration of this. The integration of this expression is 1 by 2 log 1 plus v upon 1 minus v. This is the integration of this expression here. 1 plus v upon 1 minus v. This is the integration, and you will notice it here if you substitute 1 minus v square as t. Please pay attention. If we substitute 1 minus v square as t, then we know that this results in minus 2v dv being equal to dt. And we know that v dv is equal to dt upon minus 2. And we will use this value and put it here. So as you can see that vdv is equal to dt upon minus 2 t, so minus 2t. And here at this point we get is equal to log xc. Now these two are being cancelled here, and this is log 1 plus v upon 1 minus v. And here if we integrate this expression to solve this, then we get minus 2 log t, which is equal to log xc here. Now put the value of t, this will be log here, and the value will be 1 plus v upon 1 minus v, minus 1 by 2. And here we have log. In this, the value of t is what we assumed as 1 minus v square. Therefore, it is 1 minus v square is equal to log xc. So students, as you observed that, the solution of the equation we got was log 1 plus v upon 1 minus v. And here at this point, we had minus 1 by 2. And then we had the log of 1 minus v square is equal to log of xc. Then multiply it by 2. When we multiply this by 2, we get 1 plus v upon 1 minus v minus the log of 1 minus v square, which is equal to log xc. And this 2 turns into the power of this expression here. So we have log, the whole square of 1 plus v upon 1 minus v minus log 1 minus v square. Here it will be 2 as we are multiplying this equation by 2. So this expression will be equal to log the whole square of xc, because the power will go up in this. Now we have log a minus log b, and it will be in minus. Therefore, as you can observe, when we take product of these expressions, then we get whole square of log 1 plus v upon 1 minus v. This log a minus log b is simplified as log a by b, so I will write it this way. 1 upon 1 minus v square. This expression is equal to log whole square of log xc. It was actually log a by log b, so I wrote it as 1 upon, which is the same. The logs will cancel out after simplifying. Therefore, in this step, we will get whole square of 1 plus v upon 1 minus v. In this fraction of 1 upon, I want it to be a square minus b square, which gives us 1 minus v into 1 plus v in this expression, is equal to x square and c square. As you can observe, these 1 plus v figures will cancel out. Now, the value we get is 1 plus v upon whole cube of 1 minus v, since 1 minus v are multiplied. This is equal to x square c square. Here we get 1 plus v. This will be equal to x square c square into the whole cube of 1 minus v in this expression. Now replace v with y by x. And it is equal to x square c square whole cube of 1 minus y by x. And when we take LCM of this, so here we get x plus y upon x, which is equal to x square c square into the whole cube of x minus y upon x cube. Now you can observe that we cancel these x here. This x square will be cancelled by x cube. Now the value we will get is x plus y is equal to c square into the whole cube of x minus y. Now, as you know, since we considered the value of h and k as 1, we assumed that small x is equal to capital X plus h and small y is equal to capital Y plus k. Now, the value of capital X will be small x minus h, and the value of capital Y will be y minus k. Since the value of h and k is 1, then these terms will come out to be x minus 1 and y minus 1. In the next step, we will put this value here. So, to solve this question, I will erase this part to write it, and I will show you the final answer to this. Please pay attention. In this equation, we have capital X plus capital Y, and the value of capital X is x minus 1. Plus, since capital Y is y minus 1, so we will put that value here. It is equal to c square, and now observe that here x is x minus 1. Minus y minus 1, and whole cube of this entire expression. Therefore, in the next step, x plus y minus 2, which is equal to c square. As you can see that these 1 will get cancelled out, thus we get the whole cube of x minus y. Therefore, we get the answer, and by following this method, you can easily solve this type of differential equation. I have just explained the concept of reducible to homogeneous. Now, I would like you to solve the question I provided and share the answer with me. Provide the solution to this question in the comments. While it may take a bit more time, please also include how many minutes it took to solve the question. So thank you so much for watching this. The updated differential equations video is now available and will be highly beneficial for your exam preparation. You can also explore the complete playlist of differential equation videos from my previous and new uploads. You can also check out the 2.0 series here. This is my new channel where I upload various short tricks. Feel free to subscribe to my channel, and you can follow me on Instagram as well. Thank you so much for watching. Like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Please leave your answer in the comment box. Thank you.